गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी सी द थ्योरी लेक्चर आउटकम दैट इज अ वोल्टेज एंड करंट सोर्स यूज इन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिवाइसेस और इलेक्ट्रिकल डिवाइसेस. सो ऑल ऑफ यू नो अबाउट करंट एंड वोल्टेज. दीज टू पैरामीटर्स आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक नेटवर्क. सो करंट मीन्स फ्लो ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन विच इज़ फ्लोज थ्रू द वायर, और यू कैन से दैट फ्रॉम टू वन टर्मिनल टू टू टर्मिनल सेकेंड टर्मिनल. सो करंट इज अ फ्लो ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, इट इज़ अ फ्लोइंग क्वांटिटी. एंड वोल्टेज इज नथिंग बट द पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस. पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस मीन्स यू कैन से दैट इफ वी हैव कनेक्टेड सम बैटरी वोल्टेज टू इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिवाइसेस, देन द पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस बिटवीन पॉजिटिव टर्मिनल टू निगेटिव टर्मिनल इज कॉल्ड एज अ वोल्टेज. वोल्टेज ऑलवेज मेजर्ड अक्रॉस टू टर्मिनल ऑफ द डिवाइस, एंड करंट इज ऑलवेज फ्लोइंग थ्रू वायर. सो करंट इज ऑलवेज फ्लोज, दैट्स वाई इट इज टेकन एज अ सीरीज क्वांटिटी. एंड वोल्टेज वी मेजर्ड अक्रॉस टू टर्मिनल्स, दैट्स वाई इट इज ऑलवेज इन पैरेलल कनेक्शन. नाउ दीज टू पैरामीटर्स आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. दीज आर द एनर्जी सोर्सेज टू एनी इलेक्ट्रॉनिक सर्किट. नाउ एनर्जी सोर्सेज एंड वॉट आर द एनर्जी सोर्सेज एंड वोल्टेज सोर्सेज. द एनर्जी सोर्सेज मीन्स वेन एवर वी कनेक्ट द वोल्टेज टू अवर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक सर्किट, देन वोल्टेज करंट पैरामीटर्स आर डेवलप इन अ सर्किट, बट एज वेल एज पावर इज ऑल्सो गेट्स डेसिपेटेड इन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक सर्किट्स. सो एनर्जी सोर्सेस मीन्स पावर सोर्सेस इज ऑल्सो इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक सर्किट. देन वोल्टेज सोर्सेस, देर आर डिफरेंट वोल्टेज सोर्सेस. करंट सोर्सेस, देर आर डिफरेंट करंट सोर्सेस. आइडियल एंड प्रैक्टिकल करंट एंड वोल्टेज सोर्सेस इज अवेलेबल फॉर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक सर्किट. Now, what is the relation between current and voltage? According to Ohm's law, all of we know that V is equals to IR, means current and voltage are current and voltage is always directly proportional to each other, and the resistor is a parameter which opposes the flow of current. So, what is the relation between current and voltage? According to Ohm's law, V is equals to IR. Then resistor is always used to resist the flow of current. So whenever there is a excess amount of current, the resistor helps to resist that excess amount of current. Then laws of current and laws of voltage is also designed according to Ohm's law. If we design current law, then I is equals to V upon R. That means resistance and current relation is inversely proportional. Also for voltage, it is inversely proportional. V is equals to I upon R. Then current and voltage source is a basic component of electronic circuit. As I said you, whenever we connect any power supply to electronic circuit, the current will start flowing through it. That means of flow of electrons, electrons starts flowing through the wire or network, and this flow of electron is nothing but the current. And voltage is the potential difference between battery terminals, that is positive terminal and negative terminal. So voltage and current is the most essential parameters of the any circuit. Then as I told you, current is defined as a flow of electric charge, and current is basically denoted by symbol I. The unit of current is ampere, and the SI unit of current is coulomb per second. So generally we use ampere while it is when it is related to charge, then we'll take the unit like coulomb per second. So current is generally measured in ampere, but when current start flowing through any electronic circuit, it dissipates some power and it develops some charges in circuit. So that charges is taken in coulomb per second, but generally we prefer the ampere to measure the current. The measuring element of current is ammeter. Ammeter is available in our labs, so that ammeters are used to measure the current
flowing in any electronic circuit. Then voltage is a potential difference of between two points of an electric field. Previously I have told you, whenever we connect any voltage supply or any battery to electronic circuit, there is a potential difference is developed between two terminals of the source, that is nothing but the voltage. It is denoted by symbol V, and measurement unit of measurement is volts. SI unit is joule per coulomb. Now joule means energy. So when current flows through electronic circuit, it develops charge. And whenever voltage develops across a electronic circuit, it produces energy. So to measure that energy, joule per coulomb unit is required. But generally we consider only voltage, and we'll take voltage voltmeter to measure it, and we'll take measure that voltage in volts. So these voltage and current parameters are very much important in electronic circuit. So whenever we connect any electronic circuit with battery or any supply, so these two parameters get developed in electronic circuit. So to measure that voltage and current, there are different types of voltage source and current source available in our laboratory. So we will see the types of these sources. On your screen you can see that there is a symbol of voltage source is provided. So the symbol of voltage source is one circle and two terminals are shown, that is positive and negative. So this is the representation of voltage source. So we'll consider this voltage source, this is ideal voltage source. Why it is called as ideal source? Because this source is having zero resistance, right? We'll just imagine this as an ideal voltage source. So we'll take resistance equal to zero. So if resistance equals to zero, the value of voltage source is equal to applied voltage source, because it is it doesn't having any resistance in this circuit. We are just considering that the parameter resistor is zero for ideal current so it will provide the exact amount of input voltage at the output side. That's why we'll get a stable voltage, which is shown in graph. Then again you'll see the different types of voltage symbols, voltage source symbols are shown on screen. First is a battery terminal. Battery is also providing voltage source. So positive negative terminals are shown. Then ideal voltage source is just shown with the help of circle. Inside that, upper terminal is positive and lower terminal is negative. Then again in third symbol you can see that the voltage and resistor both are connected. So in that case we will consider resistance equals to zero for ideal voltage source. Then again we will see in D figure, the voltage source, in that S sign is given. S means alternating voltage source, or you can say that AC voltage source. Then in last symbol, and there is a frequency controlled voltage source. So this is the symbol for voltage source. Then facts about voltage source. Voltage is an electromotive force which causes current to flow within a circuit. The unit of EMF is volt. EMF means electromagnetic force, which is nothing but voltage only. The volt is a potential difference between two points, as I said you earlier. When voltage starts flowing through the circuit, it generates energy in it. So that energy is measured in joules per coulomb. Joule means unit of energy, and coulomb is unit of charge. So whenever we connect voltage, it produces current, as well as it produces two electronic parameter, that is energy and charge. Real voltage source such as a batteries having resistance associated with them. कोई भी वोल्टेज सोर्स हम यूज करते हैं तो उसके साथ एक स्पेसिफिक रेजिस्टेंस होता है, उसकी वजह से करंट लिमिट में फ्लो होता है. सो एनी वोल्टेज सोर्स इज हैविंग सम अमाउंट ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस, बट फॉर आइडियल वोल्टेज सोर्स विल कंसिडर रेजिस्टेंस इक्वल्स टू जीरो. बट लेबोरेटरी में या प्रैक्टिकल यूज़ के लिए हम जो वोल्टेज सोर्स यूज़ करते हैं वहाँ उसमें थोड़ा रेजिस्टेंस होता है, जो कि ज़रूरी है क्योंकि वो रेजिस्टेंस की वजह से एक्सेस अमाउंट ऑफ करंट नहीं होता और करंट लिमिट हो जाता है. देन करंट सोर्स, लाइक वोल्टेज सोर्स, देर इज ऑल्सो टाइप ऑफ करंट सोर्स, दैट इज आइडियल करंट सोर्स. सो ऑन स्क्रीन यू कैन सी द सिम्बल ऑफ करंट सोर्स. This is ideal current source, and we'll again consider for this ideal current source resistance is infinite, or we can say that resistance is zero. So whenever we talk about the voltage and current relations, so it is defined with the help of Ohm's law, that is V is directly proportional to I, or we can say that V is equals to IR. So for I, the equation will be V upon R, or for R it is V upon I. So current through resistor causes a power dissipation. Recently I have told you power dissipate hoti hai, that power is given like P is equals to I V, or P is equals to V square R, or P is equals to I square R. The components used to oppose the flow of current through it is called as a resistor. एक्सेस अमाउंट होती है, अगर बढ़ सकती है करंट की, अगर हमने उसको लिमिट नहीं किया तो वो इलेक्ट्रॉनिक सर्किट को डैमेज कर सकती है. इसीलिए जो कोई भी वोल्टेज सोर्स हो उसके साथ रेजिस्टेंस डिफाइन किया जाता है, दैट रेजिस्टर विल यूज टू अपोज द एक्सेस अमाउंट ऑफ फ्लो ऑफ करंट. Then these are voltage and currents are vector quantities, so you can simply add it or subtract it while calculating the number of currents. Then you can add the voltages if there are number of electronic circuit or number of electronic path is there. Then you can simply add the different voltage source to each other. Then we'll see the nodes provided to you. So these are the nodes of today's TLO which is provided to you. So in this you can see that the definition of voltage and current source is given. These are the power energy sources which is important to electronic circuit. Then types of voltage source and current source is given, which is we have seen in presentation. That is independent. So independent voltage source means the voltage sources does not depend on any current or any another voltage source. Independently it can able to produce potential difference inside the electronic circuit is called as an independent voltage source. Then independent voltage source is having two types, ideal and practical. As I said you, ideal voltage source means we are considering the resistance equal to zero, so we'll get same amount of voltage which is provided the input voltage. Then if practical voltage source is there, then some resistance is always available with that voltage source, which is used to resist the excess amount of current. So practical voltage source is having some amount of resistance, ideal voltage source is having zero amount of resistance.
Likewise, same you can draw for ideal current source. In PPTs, ideal current source diagrams are provided. Also, explanation regarding that is provided. So, this is all about today's lecture. Thank you.